The Philippines' top diplomat apologizes to his Chinese counterpart, Foreign Minister Wang Yi. That's one day after the Philippine Foreign Affairs Chief Teodoro Locsin Jr. fired an expletive-laden social media post, telling China in no uncertain terms to get out of Philippine waters. Locsin initially said he is only apologizing to Wang, whose opinion matters to him. The tweet, however, seems to have been deleted. At his regular press briefing today, Duterte spokesman Harry Roque confirmed the apology.
Sinabi po ni Secretary Locsin ay kanyang personal na pananaw. Ano mang pagkakaiba natin po sa bansang China sa usapin ng West Philippine Sea, hindi ito magde-define ng ating bilateral relations at hindi rin ito magiging hadlang sa ating pakikipagkaibigan sa China.
President Rodrigo Duterte denying making any campaign promises on the sea dispute with China. In his speech Monday night, Duterte said dealing with China's latest incursions in Philippine waters would have to be done through diplomacy. However, Duterte's statement runs contrary to his famous remark during a 2016 presidential debate, where he said he would ride a jet ski to plant a Philippine flag on the Spratly Islands. Duterte later clarified that his jet ski remark was not meant to be taken literally.
I never, never in my campaign as president promised the people that I would retake the West Philippine Sea. I did not promise that I would pressure China. I never mentioned about China and the Philippines in my campaign because that was a very serious matter. We need to have a diplomatic tokatis dyan. Eh, hindi ako dyan. Munan dyan sa ating foreign affairs. Trabaho nila yan.
Duterte also hurled insults at former Philippine government officials who earlier accused him of not protecting the country's interests in Philippine waters.
Itong Albert na ito, ako pa ang sinisisi. Makita kita, suntukin kita. Buang ka. Ako ang pakialam man, ako ang nakialam na pagdating ko, nandiyan na yung barko ng China. Ang atin ang wala. Ito si Carpio, tumaba na ng gusto. Walang ginawa kung hindi magdadaan, tumahime ka nga. Tapos madaldada ako, nagamura. Eh, bakit? Ganun naman talaga ako.
For an international studies professor, anything that the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says or does against China will not hold water because of President Duterte's contrasting statements. Professor Renato De Castro's remark comes after Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Locsin Jr. told Beijing to get out of the West Philippine Sea in an expletive-laced tweet. De Castro notes both statements only show a divided government without a coherent strategy and a clear foreign policy on China. He also says China will only take the Philippines seriously if Manila taps ally countries such as the U.S., Australia, and Japan.
The best action that this government could take at this point in time is to rely on our alliance and our security partners. But what is basically the policy of this entire government? You have the visiting forces agreement been abrogated last year, although it's been renewed every 6 months. Then, of course, you have the non-implementation of the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement with the United States. Our allies are confused. They simply don't know who is basically setting out the policy. Of course, they would like to deal with the Secretary of Foreign Affairs. They would like the Defense Department to push through with a renegotiated or at least with a stable visiting force agreement, but once we deal with policy, once we deal at the top, there's simply confusion.